one of Blackpool's most popular attractions. Thousands of children, including grown-up ones, flock here for its rides. It was founded nearly a century ago by William Bean. Well, it's changed a lot since then, but it's still overseen by his daughter, Mrs. Doris Thompson, who's now 84. And she keeps an eagle eye on its running from her offices overlooking the rides, and her son and grandchildren are carrying on the tradition.
Well, Mrs. Thompson, your father started all this many, many years ago. How did it all happen? How did he get the first idea?
Well, that was because at the age of 19, he went to America. A lot of young people did that in those days, didn't they? And he had the idea of being a designer or maybe a journalist or something like that, and probably started in that way, and then found he wasn't doing too well. And as he described to me as a small child, he wasn't eating too well. And so he decided on something else and became involved in the Philadelphia Toboggan Company. And during that time, he traveled a lot, I think. And one of the rides he decided would be, he would bring over and try in England, was actually, it was called the Hotchkiss Bicycle Railway. And it was a ride really devised to carry workmen across a ravine from their homes to their place of work. And he must have thought this is a sort of what might be a novel idea to use as an amusement device, and he brought that over and started in Brighton and in Great Yarmouth. And then he was a Londoner, actually, you see, and began to realize that the North Country had something to offer, and particularly Blackpool, which was a very bracing, healthy place and was growing rapidly. And all the inland towns, you see, provided holidaymakers throughout the season. Mm-hmm. And he thought that was a better bid for him. And so he started here.
What was it like for you growing up here as a child?
Well, it was a simple, much simpler, much less sophisticated, of course, and children could run about and play quite happily, and I used to run down here, we live quite near, and I was able to go and ride on my favourite, which was then the Helter Skelter, and I had more or less the freedom of the place. And one of my earliest recollections was, in those days, Blackpool, there were a lot of gypsies here. And actually, gypsies were living on this very ground where we're on now. And by being a little tactful, and he'd managed to move them a little because it was the land he'd bought. Mm. So he got rid of them. But we have actually working for us today, semi-retired, but still working, a gypsy who was born on this land. And he's, as soon as he could, he was working for us, and he's been with us ever since.
There isn't that wonderful?
Yes, and his name is Reg Young, that's it.
And so you remember all these people when you were a child?
Oh, yes, and I remember him working on the water chute, which was a very much more exciting ride than the present water chute, where you came down a big slide on a free-moving, flat-bottom boat, and it plunged down into the water with a man standing at the back with a pole, and he ferried you to the side. That was free, and you know, you got jolly wet, as a matter of fact.
Free fall.
But that, yes.
And what's the oldest ride on the Pleasure Beach?
The oldest ride is the Flying Machine, and that was built in 1904. It's a wonderful, wonderfully built thing, because we still have the same machinery. And now we've made a feature of that machinery, and we've painted it up, and we have a glass in front so people can see it working.
And do the old traditional rides still give the youngsters of today a kick just as much as the new ones do?
Oh, I think they do. The Dipper, the Big Dipper, which was built in my father's time, it was the last ride he put up. Mm. And, you know, I remember at the time he was putting, it cost a lot of money, you see, in those days. We would think it a small amount now, no doubt. Mm. But he then put the price up to ride, you see, and it was to be a shilling instead of sixpence. That was the common amount, as a rule, that they charged. And people said, "Oh, Mr. Bean, a shilling for a roller coaster? It only lasts about a couple of minutes, you know." And he said, "Yes, yes," he said, "it's expensive, I know. But then, you see, for that, I shall give them a mahogany pay desk and a terrazzo entrance floor.
That's pretty good.
And just what's it like to ride on the Big Dipper?
Oh, it feels very exhilarating. Very exhilarating. The point is, you should sit down, relax, let the car take you, go with the ride. You know, you've got these big dips. Don't hold back.
Let yourself go.
Go with the ride, let yourself go, and it's very enjoyable, very exhilarating. I can do that any time. And, of course, as my father used to say, it's a counter-irritant, you see, because while you're riding it, you really can't think of anything else.